the PRP scam for ovarian rejuvenation. I'm always amazed by how creative infertility specialists are in coming up with new treatment options to treat infertile couples. For example, the latest racket, maybe not latest, it's been going on for quite a few years, is to advise women with poor ovarian reserve and even women with ovarian failure to do what is called ovarian rejuvenation treatment by injecting ovarian stem cells into the ovary. And the dream and the hope and the promise is that these stem cells will magically start creating eggs. Everyone knows what stem cells do, but unfortunately what they don't know is that ovarian stem cells don't behave the way they're supposed to behave, and just injecting these into the ovary will not magically cause the ovary to start producing eggs. The problem, of course, is that the ICMR actually bans stem cell therapy for clinical treatments because they know that it's useless. And the clever way these infertility specialists get around that ban is by not calling it ovarian stem cells, but by calling it PRP. Now, this is clever because PRP is not banned, and in fact, PRP is useful for certain stuff. For example, for treating men with balding, so you inject it in the hair follicles, so it causes hair follicles to grow, or sometimes even in shoulder joints, so orthopedic surgeons use it. But this plasma-enriched platelets, which are supposed to contain stem cells and growth factors, do not help to improve ovarian quality, ovarian reserve. But once infertility specialists have found a new tool, and especially these are desperate patients for whom we don't have a treatment, they start injecting this PRP left, right, center. Great way of making money because it's such a simple treatment. And not only do they inject it in the ovary, they also inject it in the endometrium, saying, oh, we'll grow your endometrium. I wish they would stop doing this, because giving false hope to patients whom you can't help is actually the most cruel thing to do. And this is why patients need to invest in information therapy to make sure doctors do not take them for a ride.